When a traumatic experience travels from one generation to the next and affects those who had no direct involvement with the original incident, it's called transgenerational trauma. There are three main theories about how this happens. When a parent suffers from trauma, they often develop heightened emotional sensitivity, anxiety, and emotional detachment. These reactions then shape how they interact with their children, and that's how the trauma travels to the next generation. For example, if you are raised by a traumatized mother, you might pick up on her fears and absorb her insecurities, which then influence how you perceive and handle risks. When this becomes part of your daily life during your most formative years, it can lead to a deep distrust of anything unfamiliar. As an adult, you may end up passing those insecurities on to your own children. Researchers suggest that these emotional imprints can affect emotional regulation, risk perception, and educational performance for generations. Devastating historical events and their impact on sociological structures can trap multiple generations in cycles of collective trauma. Canadian residential schools, which were designed to assimilate Indigenous children, are one example. For a century, these schools stripped young Native kids of their cultural identity and forced them to adopt Western traditions, often exposing them to physical and emotional abuse. Later, the children found it difficult to reintegrate into society, facing broken relationships, loss of cultural identity, poverty, and substance abuse, ultimately passing their trauma on to their own children, continuing the cycle. Over time, these behaviors become so deeply ingrained into social norms that it's almost impossible to distinguish between what's cultural and what stems from a traumatic response. More recent studies suggest that genes can be affected by bad experiences. Trauma can leave molecular tags on genes, and these tags can be passed down to future generations. Later on, they can alter how genes are expressed and how they control the body, possibly to prepare the next generation for a stressful life. In one example, researchers have found that Holocaust survivors carry epigenetic markers linked to anxiety, which can then be passed on to their offspring. Their children showed heightened sensitivity to stress and were more prone to developing anxiety, depression, and PTSD themselves, even if they didn't experience any trauma firsthand. Substance abuse, often used as a coping mechanism by those suffering emotional wounds, can further reinforce epigenetic changes. Children of parents who struggled with drugs and alcohol often have inherent predispositions that make them more vulnerable to addiction, a vicious cycle rooted in raw biological effects. So which of the three is it? Well, it's complicated. Take, for instance, a man who survives war. The initial trauma changes his character and that of the generation of men around him. The man's daughter, who is still young when he returns from war, is affected by his emotional coping mechanisms, leading to stress-related tags on her own genes. When the daughter herself becomes a parent, her boy inherits some of these epigenetic markers and later copies some of his grandfather's behavior without ever meeting the man in person. One way to break the cycle of transgenerational trauma is to face our own history, developing a deep understanding of our parents' pain and the scars they inherited during childhood. The Hoffman process is one approach that aims to guide people through this. Once we understand our roots, we might be able to weed out some of the rotten parts and help the next generation to grow up strong and healthy. What are your thoughts? Do you feel the weight of a burden that was never yours? And if so, what are your coping mechanisms? Tell us your thoughts and experiences in the comments below. We relentlessly researched education for the past decade, read plenty of peer-reviewed papers, visited all sorts of schools, created hundreds of videos on the topic, and even set up our very own kindergarten for project-based learning. And now, we also made a book. The Unschooler's Educational Dictionary covers everything we know about learning, unveils the unintended consequences of compulsory education, and includes a complete guide to the alternative school movement. Order your copy now. Just visit your favorite bookshop or check the links in the description below. If you found this helpful, check out our other videos. Join us on YouTube or on patreon.com/sprouts. For more information, classroom exercises, or videos without background music, visit sproutschools.com. Published under Creative Commons.